Hello and welcome to the Tech Mojo. This is Nilan, and today in this video, we'll see how to validate the configuration properties in Spring Boot application startup. The configuration properties annotation in Spring Boot is used to bind the configuration parameters, typically from your application property or application YAML file, to a Java class. But did you know we can also validate these configurations at Spring Boot application startup? Let's dive in. Now let's say we have a Spring Boot application called import a service and that import the data into the database. But for the importer to work, we need certain configurations like file path, file type, and thread pool size. The importer service is pretty empty at this moment, but we are logging the configuration here. So for my importer service to work, we are injecting the importer configuration and the importer config is injected through the constructor. Okay, because I'm using Lombok. Lombok does provide required argument constructor, and through the constructor, Spring will inject the importer config. Now let's look into the importer config. Now in the importer config, we are using the configuration properties annotation, and it is prefixed with importer.service. Now with configuration properties annotation, Spring Boot will automatically bind all these configurations defined within your application YAML to your Java class automatically. So we don't have to do anything. It happens automatically when you have a configuration properties annotation defined. One thing to note is the name of these properties should match exactly to the name of the fields defined within your configuration class. Now let us run this application and we will see the configuration being printed. Obviously, this is an example for the demonstration purpose, so I haven't really implemented any data import logic. But if you have a data import logic, then you can pick up the importer config values and you can work from there. Now, let's say we want to ensure the importer configuration is provided and also meets the validation criteria when the application starts. If there are any validation failures, then application should fail during the startup. If we want to do the validation, then we need to have a JSR 380 implementation, something like a Hibernate validator in your class path. So let us first add the validator. Let's go back to our build Gradle file. And within our build Gradle file, we need to add the Spring Boot startup validation dependency. That's it. So let's resync this. Now, once we have the validator in our class path, we need to explicitly enable the configuration property validation using the validated annotation. So inside our importer config, we need to provide it validated annotation. So we now have enabled the validation, but we haven't provided any validation criteria yet. So let's add some validations. In JSR 380, we have many different type of validation provided out of box. Things like you can use not null, not empty, size, email validation, or we can also use regular expression to validate certain criteria. Now in this example, let us ensure that the file path is provided. So we want to do it as not empty. So the file path must be provided for my importer service to work. Now similarly for file type, also, let's provide not empty. Okay, so file path must be provided. And similarly, for the thread pool size, let's make it a positive number. Okay, so it should be a positive number. And also for the thread pool size, let us ensure that the maximum thread pool size should not exceed the number 10. So for that, we can use max annotation. And here we can provide 10. Again, 10 is a very arbitrary number. You can define your maximum thread pool size based on your requirement. Now for the file type, let's add another validation. And we want to ensure that the file type must be a CSV type or a TXT type. So we can do that using the regular expression. And for regular expression to work, we need to provide pattern. And to the pattern, we need to provide the regular expression. Okay, so let's provide a regular expression to validate that the file path should have an extension .csv. So .csv dollar That is all we need to do. The file type must be a CSV or TXT. If none of this found, then the validation should fail. Now let's go back to our application property. So right now we have defined a file path, and for the file type we have defined CSV, and thread pool size we have defined 3. Now let's increase the thread pool size to 30, which is not valid based on the validation criteria we have provided, so it should fail. And similarly for the file type, let's provide some other format like docs. So this should fail the validation when your application starts. Okay, so as you can see, the validation has been failed and you're getting a bind exception. And it also logs the detailed validation failures. For example, the property file type is a docs, and it also shows you that it is not matching the regular expression. And similarly for the thread pool size, currently it is configured for 30, but it must be less than or equals 10. Okay, so this is all you need to do to validate your configuration properties at application startup. You need a JSR 380 implementation, something like Hibernate validator in your class path. And once you have that, then you can define the validated annotation. And to your configuration class, you can define all the validation that you have. And you can also write your own custom validation implementation using the Hibernate validator. Okay, so this is all for today. If you have any question, please let me know in the comment section below. I'll happy to answer as soon as I can. Thanks for watching and see you in the next one.